In this video, I am going to explain how to do neural manipulation for suprascapular nerve. This nerve is very, very important for scapula and shoulder joint. This nerve originates from C4, C5, and C6. Some anatomy books say it's from C5 and C6, but in this video, I say it's from C4, 5, and 6. Okay, it's from cervical spines and it penetrates this space. This is scapular notch. This is very tiny space. So when people do throwing sports, you know, you use scapula a lot, this chronic movement may create a friction here, then that can aggravate nervous tissue. Make sense? Then it runs like this, runs like this. I usually approach from two parts. First part is this one, right on the scapular notch. But where is good landmark to palpate? It's clavicle, this part. You know, suprascapular nerve is just below this part of clavicle, right here. You see that? Now, when you can find this part, I put my thumb deep into scapula, like this. Imagine this person is on supine position. Now, I put my thumb from this place and put finger like this. You see that? Now, I put traction towards this way because this is distal way of nervous tissue. It's very important. I find this curve, sink into the nervous tissue. Imagine I am on nervous tissue. Then I put traction this way. This is exaggeration. You don't pull this much, just tiny bit and little bit off. Don't let your touch off completely, okay? Put traction and a little bit off. The nervous tissue starts to move. This is, of course, exaggeration. Then you follow this movement until this movement finishes. Sink in, put traction a little bit off, you move, then you stop when nervous tissue stops moving. This is, you know, exaggeration. It's very tiny, subtle movement. This is first place through this part of clavicle, okay? Next part is this part. Actually, there's bifurcation around here. One branch goes to here, one branch goes to this way. This nerve innervates supraspinatus, infraspinatus, acromioclavicular joint, and glenohumeral joint. That is why this nerve is freaking important for scapula and shoulder joint. Anyway, how do you find this place? You know, this is right inferior from acromion, okay? You find spine of scapula, then you end up to acromion. This bifurcation is just inferior from acromion. Okay, imagine there is bifurcation here. So you put finger here. You know, actually this is superimposition. I put middle finger, but for sake of this video, I use thumb, okay? I usually use middle finger for superimposition like this, okay? Okay, I found nervous tissue, then I put traction medially or laterally. Which one got more tension? Then let's say I find tension this way. Now I put traction, a little bit off, starts to move. I follow the movement until it finishes. How about the other way? Same thing. I put finger, put traction this way, not this much, this way, little bit off. It starts to move. You follow movement until this movement finishes. All the movement I do is just exaggeration. It's very tiny, very subtle movement. People never know what you're doing if they're looking from outside. It's that small movement. Again, I usually do this technique on patient superimposition. But if I do this, you don't see what I'm doing. That is why I show you exact placement on this position. I work on this place on superimposition, and I work on this place on superimposition. This technique is very good for people who use scapula and shoulder a lot. Maybe people who play basketball, baseball, tennis, volleyball, or maybe people do upper body training a lot. It's very good technique. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.